Hi everyone, I'm glad you're here. Thank you so much for joining me today. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed and thumbs up my videos. They've been having an earthquake swarm there in New Zealand along the western coast. It started out with a magnitude 5.9 earthquake at about 16 a.m. and it's been ongoing. Earthquake swarms are not unusual there in New Zealand. They can last several days or even weeks. And according to geologists there, they say most of them are caused by the movement of the tectonic plates. Now, according to the New Zealand Herald, there has been damage, even though, some places are saying there wasn't any damage. It says here, houses and business are damaged and some are fleeing after a swarm of earthquakes. Some severe hit Hawkeye's Bay this morning and felt across the North Island. At least a dozen quakes have been recorded, beginning with the magnitude 5.9 tremor at a depth of 22 kilometers. So that would be about 13 and a half miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. We just got smashed by the biggest earthquake I've ever felt, one Porangahau local wrote on Facebook. SHIT is flying everywhere out of the cupboards and shelves. A second just started our house, is rocking uncontrollably. The man said he never felt such huge earthquakes and said he was forced out of his home. We are getting in our car, too dangerous in the house. The shakes are continuing. A staff member of Duke Hotel in Porangahau was in the upstairs office when the whole building shook from side to side. The only thing I managed to save was the computer in front of me. It's all damaged. Everything is on the ground. The National Emergency Management Agency posted that there is no tsunami threat from the earthquake near Porangahau. We hope everyone is feeling okay. Remember, drop, cover, and hold is the right action to take in an earthquake, and they give you a link to GeoNet, and they have it listed, and you can see we got several areas which are considered extremely strong intensity. GeoNet has this listed, and you can see the area where the 5.9 occurred, extreme intensity. Yeah, it was felt all the way over to Sydney. Let me bring this over. Way up over here. A staff member at the Iron Museum in Porangahau said a lot of bottles and display items had fallen to the floor. There's an image that was shared on New Zealand Herald's webpage. Here's a Twitter post from Dr. Samantha Keene. This earthquake can go away right now. Stuck on the 11th floor of my building. And then there was two replies. I hear you. 11th floor of, I don't know, VZ is pretty interesting too. Bad enough on my 4th floor apartment. Now there's also a Twitter post that says, feel sorry for the people in Wingary whose building collapsed or was severely damaged. One of the replies was, is the usual Acklander in there? Noting that the city has been wiped out, ? Another reply says, "Wep, yep, that's a long wobble here in Welly, but I am on the 12th floor." Another post, extreme shaking in Walgary. Sorry for pronouncing it wrong, you guys. So there was also a 5.4 and a 5.2, and I want to use Google Earth and go to that area of Walgary. I'm not sure. Oh my goodness, it's way up north there. Right there. Wow. Let's bring this back out to see the location and about how far it is from where these earthquakes have been occurring. All right, let's try and measure it. Okay, so we got Walgary. Yeah, they're probably saying, quit saying it wrong. 318, maybe 20, 25 miles. Look at that. Now, Nancy Dollar is asking if it's from the same fault that brought us Wellington Airport. No, they just say it's tectonic movement. The plates are on the move. Here we have the Kermadec Trench drawn out in red. It's called the Tonga Termadec Arch, where two tectonic plates in the Southwest Pacific converge. This volcano is one of a chain of largely submarine volcanoes that extend all the way from New Zealand to the southwest of Fiji, the north, northeast. The Pacific plate subducts underneath the Indo-Australian plate. Yep, that's what's going on. So there was no tsunami warning, no need to go to higher ground, but there is a post here that says if you headed to higher ground this morning after that shake, you did exactly the right thing. Well done. Another Twitter post, Isabel Crawthorne, Northern Explorer stopped unusually at Martin, awaiting track inspection. So a rare glimpse of the once bustling little piece of regional rail. Someone else posted on Twitter, two of the closest known faults, and we got the Yippee Fault and the T-Uri Fault. So here on GeoNet we got the 5.9, the 5.4, 3.4, another 3.4, let's see, a 3.0, another 3.0, a 4.3, the 2.8, a 1.9, a 2.9, another 2.9, a 3.2. My goodness, they're getting a lot of them. 2.1, a 2.3, a 2.5, a 2.0. Someone said there was about 16 of them. I think there's more. 3.6, 2.3, 3.4, a 2.4. 2.8, 2.0, 2.6, 2.8. Boy, it goes on and on. 1.8, 1.3, a 3.4, a 2.6, another 3.4, a 2.3. How many is that? I just refreshed the page. We got a 1.8, a 2.7, a 2.2. They're a day ahead of us, so it's let's see, 12:02 p.m. there, 11:58 a.m. Yeah, oh my goodness. You guys be safe over there. Yeah, it might be smart to get in your car and go out to an open parking lot and just wait it out. But these quakes can actually last days, if not weeks. So, yeah, did you feel them? And how long did they last? Did you get dizzy? How did your pets react? Pets are often a very good indicator before an earthquake strikes. Yeah, please put those comments down below. And be safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.